What is Jakarta EE and why I, as Java developer, should pay attention on it? On this video, I will explain both. Hello you, my name is Otavio Santana and welcome to my YouTube channel, the channel for you who wants to become an ultimate software engineer applying the best practices of open source to move your career forward. So subscribe. Let's reply first, what is Jakarta EE? So in the past, we had three different platforms driven by Oracle Sun. The Java SE, or Standard Edition, the Java ME, I guess Micro Edition, and finally, the Java EE, or the Enterprise Editions. Based on several discussions that we had between community, JCP, and so on, everybody agreed to move the Java EE, or the Java Enterprise, under Eclipse Foundation umbrella. Based on that, we could move the code, but we could not keep the name for copyright reasons. We need to change the name. So instead of use Java EE, we used Jakarta EE. So the goal is still the same, to define and simplify the life of Java developer who gonna use that on production, especially on enterprise side. So Jakarta EE and Java EE both are the same. The difference is the Java EE is a past. So Jakarta EE is the former Java EE. Okay, so Jakarta EE is the enterprise edition. So Jakarta EE is the house of the Java enterprise. Based on that, everybody who is using Java are using, in the majority, Jakarta EE. Especially because doesn't matter if you are using Spring, you are using Quarkus, Helidon, and so on. You might using Jakarta EE right now. Why? Because Jakarta EE holds the specification, so defines several common API where the enterprise products can use on the top. For example, Spring is using Spring Data JPA. JPA stands for the Java Persistence API. Right now it's become Jakarta Persistence API, where the goal is to do the communication between Java and relational database. Or we have the Java servlets that Spring is using as well. I don't know if you remember that Spring had a big change, and that's happened because with the transition between IP, where we move from the Oracle to Eclipse Foundation, we also need to change the package name. So instead of use the Javax package name, we start using Jakarta as package name. And that's the main reason of we have right now this big change between Jakarta EE 8 or Java EE 8 with Jakarta EE 9, where we had the big bang, the huge change. So it's happened only because the IP change has happened in the past. So the Jakarta EE is an umbrella of specifications where you can choose or use as a platform or profile. So you can use a single specification, for example, if you want to use just to define the RESTful application, that is the Jakarta RESTful application, or if you want to do the relationship database, that is the Jakarta Persistence, or you can use as a platform, for example, web profile from Jakarta EE, or so on. So Jakarta will provide those kind of things for you. Furthermore, we have the current version, that is Jakarta EE11, that brings new specifications for you, especially the Jakarta data, where the goal is to simplify the communication between data and Java, where you can have several ways to use repository and do the communication using a single interface. So super straightforward to do queries, to do the communications, and so on. And one thing that we are using and working a lot in Jakarta EE is to have a year release. So the goal is to every year we release a new version with new features, new capabilities to make your life as Java developer even easier. Okay, so I talked about Jakarta EE 11. Right now we are working in Jakarta EE 12 with amazing features that include the inclusion of Jakarta NoSQL inside the web platform. We also have the new specification that is Jakarta Query, where you can take a look that the goal is to have a common communication between or among the Java database specification. So a single query language for Jakarta persistence, Jakarta Query, and Jakarta NoSQL. So that is the overall of the Java or Enterprise or Jakarta EE for today. So if you have any questions, please let me know. And again, the Jakarta EE is umbrella specification from community, is open source, where you can contribute as much as you wish. So give your thoughts, give your suggestions, and please let me know what specifications you are using right now from Jakarta. Thank you.